As one storm system leaves after giving blizzard conditions and 8 inches of snow in Sandy Hook, New Jersey, and hitting central and south Jersey pretty good, and completely ripping off New England, I've been talking about this, that the mean storm track is going to be shifting further south. Now, we're looking at a water vapor loop over here, and as you can see, the Boston blizzard is pulling away. You ask for too much of something, and you set yourself up for disappointment. As this storm lifts northeastward, it will create a block. A high-pressure system will be coming down, and it could be a fairly strong one. Now, this is very critical, because depending on how strong this high-pressure system is will dictate how far north the snow will get. If the high-pressure system is too far south and strong, it suppresses the snow for a good chunk of southern New England, and the flurry fringe probably would not get past Massachusetts, period. Maybe even northern Connecticut. So I don't see this being a New England special. I do believe the models are going to trend the storm more north, but I think the farthest possibly north the storm can go is Cape May. I now see the storm coming any further north, as it is developing down in this area over here. So, I just recently got a winter storm watch for over 5 inches of snow. I think it's a little bit bold for the National Weather Service to do, because at this exact and current time, I do not see me getting greater than 5 inches. However, if you do factor in ratios with the snow, that makes sense, as the European model would give me about 5 to 8 inches. But you know how this winter's been going, overperforming, and errors that are busting. So right now, what I think is my thought, I'm going to outline the areas where I think the northern fringe of the snow is going to be with this southern slider, that's exactly what it is. It's going to kind of go something like this. Now this is going to be a rough draft. I'm only going to cover a certain area, so it's going to be pretty broad. And you know what? I'll use blue. Right now, the most northern fringe of this event I see running just around Boston. I think Worcester is on that line over there. Springfield, I do not think northwestern Connecticut is going to get a snowstorm. But, you know, this thing can trend further north. I would really take this down sort of like that. That's how I'm seeing things right now. And this is the most northern fringe. This is not snowstorm area. When you get into the dark blue, I think that's when you start to set up your chance for about a moderate snowstorm. And I'm going to take this right around the Plymouth area, Providence. I don't see Hartford being in it. I'd take this through southwestern Connecticut. And it kind of goes like that. That's where your moderate snowstorm is going to be. Your heavy snowstorm. This is where the potential of a foot could potentially play out if the storm continues to come further north. I'm going to have to go way down towards Atlantic City. I don't see that in Philadelphia even. We're going to take this right through like that. North of Dover. I see Baltimore being in it. Washington, D.C., so basically, right now, I think 6 to 12 inches for a bold start looks a great possibility up in here. Even though that this is 6 to 8, I think the storm is going to come a little bit further north, and you have 6 to 12 over here. This is premeditated thoughts. I like a good 3 to 6 in this area. You know what? I'm going to put plus in here as well, because some shorter models are coming in with guidance bringing the storm further north. And then once you get up into this area over here, I think it's 1 to 3. But I'm going to put a plus because, like I said, I think it can come further north. But, you know, South Jersey, Cape May County, south of inland, Baltimore, D.C., Annapolis, Dover, I think this is really the storm for you guys. Now, that is to be determined if it comes further north, but I don't see this being a New England special. I do not see all of a sudden now Boston gets a foot of snow. That's not happening. Not with this. I told you guys that the mean storm track is shifting south, and this is evidently clear that that's going to happen. I'm going to be making the premeditated Axis snowfall map. Depending if my thoughts change, it should look like this. Otherwise, it will look different, and it should cover a more broad area. But right now, this is definitely a South Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, Baltimore, D.C. special. I even have Philly not even in the worst of it. Not yet, at least. However, this 6 to 12 can creep up like that. But we'll see how that works out. I'm going to go and save this real quick. Now, if we go over to some model guidance over here. And let me tell you something. Some of these models are really starting to come north with everything. But I'm going to go back on my Twitter page real quick. And, oh good, Bernie Reno's making his videos. Let me go over to the photos and videos section over here. And we can really see what models are starting to do now. I mean, if you look over here, the NMM model, and especially the R model, gets aggressive with this really coming north. And it really just nails Tom's River, again, with a 2 to 3 inch per hour band of snow. But, factoring ratios coming in, this is why winter storm watches are being so far extended north. 8 inches here. This seems to be a little bit overdone, but I can assure you that this is not happening. This is not happening. This has not happened since 1994. So this is not happening. It's another reason why I think that this is going to come further north. Before the DFS had a bullseye out over in Southeast Virginia, that never happens either. So that's the reason why winter storm watches are up, because of high ratio snows. If this was a 10 to 1 ratio, your winter storm watches would be confined into this area going down. So those are my current thoughts right now. And I kind of broke down, you know, what the different models are doing and how things are working out. I also mentioned about the warm anomaly that down the road that these storms might cause mixing issues in the Boston area. So that's all I can say right now.